Parliament yesterday reconsidered the Budget Appropriation Bill 2024, which President Yoweri Museveni had declined to sign and approved without major challenges. The total government expenditure for the new financial year is projected at 72.1 trillion. It consists of a total appropriation of about 37.7 trillion shillings and statutory expenditure of 34.8 trillion. President Yoweri Museveni returned the bill for reconsideration after the executive took issue with Parliament over several amendments it had made to it. These amendments saw 750.47 billion shillings reallocated from its priorities.
Therefore, diverting the 3.1 trillion in 4 years is equivalent to aborting 9 big roads of the Kampala massacre type or a much larger number of a smaller roads.
The president said in his letter that for 4 years, MPs have altered allocations to critical government objectives amounting to 3.7 billion shillings.
There are three mistakes involved here. These are indiscipline in budgeting, sabotaging the national priorities, and now the suspicion of massive corruption.
The president warned legislators against this alteration to the budget allocation without consultation with the executive.
No reshuffling of the budget ever happened again without an input of the executive.
The delay to assent could have affected the release of funds for salaries and wages, according to the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, who chaired the special sitting yesterday. Former Deputy Resident City Commissioner Herbert Anderson Burora was arrested over spreading hate speech against the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among using his X platform. He was arrested from his home in Ntinda, Kampala. Moments before his arrest, he posted on his X, "My home has been besieged by unknown men who claim that I should go with them." He was taken to Kira Division Police Station at around 2 p.m. He was transferred to Kampala Central Police Station to record a statement.
Police have been Parliament. Yetugamba mumutwara wani bagamana fita tumanyi tugenda kuza bakamba bafi. Defend the information mamuli ta ku CPS. Yetugende we waka. Bakora search. Tetwate gidebwa de bagara ne tebabufunye.
According to Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson Patrick Onyango, Burora was arrested on charges of spreading hate speech and malicious information, which is contrary to the Computer Misuse Act 2022.
Kimukwasiza. Songa. Yokusiga obukyayi n'okukozesa bubi mutimbagano.
Cyber harassment attracts a maximum sentence of 3 years or a fine of 1.4 million shillings.
Kati tumanyi kyekidda mu maaso era tebatubuulidde ki kye bazaako oba bamutwala mu kkooti oba misango ki gye bamukuddeko era tuli awo tulinze. Kuba wano ne bannange tugenda kugoberera ne paramilitary police tulabe biki byegenda otubuulira ku musibe wano.
The United Kingdom heads to the polls tomorrow in a general election that is expected to see the main opposition Labour Party return to power after 14 years. The Labour Party is 99% certain to secure more seats than when it won a landslide victory in 1997, a new poll said yesterday. Led by Keir Starmer, a former human rights lawyer and chief public prosecutor, the party, out of power since 2010, is predicted to claim 484 out of a total of 650 seats in what would be an unprecedented victory in modern British history. However, the right-wing ruling Conservatives and the centric Liberal Democrats are in a close race to come to a distant second and form the country's official opposition.
But obviously it is an election that's all about change. You know, the opportunity is to vote to continue with what we've got. In my view, that's not been very good. Or we can vote to change that and have a different government come in and start cleaning up the mess and taking our country forward. But it is a vote.
The UK Conservatives hoped Rishi Sunak would stabilise the party and country when they made him leader following his predecessor's chaotic tenures. He has been credited for slashing inflation but criticised for failing in cutting health waiting lists, stopping irregular immigration and sending migrants to Rwanda.
Now Boris is right to say now is the time.
for all Conservatives to come together to deny Labour that supermajority that Keir Starmer craves. We have 48 hours to save Britain from the danger of a Labour government.
Other candidates include Nigel Farage, a 60-year-old ex-member of the European Parliament, Ed Davey, John Sweeney, and Carla Denyer.